Now, my sweet mother would not let us say that word.
Oh. She wasn't looking at me in the back mouth. So I get a little older, and I start hanging with my older cousins. Now, they're riding around listening to, like, Juvenile, Bone Thugs and Harmony, Usher. And I knew that I was predestined to love R&B music. The first time that I heard,
it's 7 o'clock on the dot, and I'm gonna drive back to the street. Oh, got a real pretty little thing that's waiting on me. A cool love, anticipating. Good love, don't hit me when I got my hands upon my
a few years later, we were riding around singing. Now, I'm not trying to be rude, but hey, pretty girl, I'm getting you. They ain't doing the things you do. I mean, my lips are true. That's why I'm always thinking, girl, trying to get you to a hotel. Must be a football coach. The way you got me playing the field. And baby, give me that. Baby, give me that. And then your hands beat my throat. Now, I said, I'm 24. Mama said, I'm a lady. It's the remix to ignition.
I'm like, so what, I'm drunk. It's the freaking weekend, baby, I'm about to have me some fun.
So now, between high school and heading up to Nashville, Tennessee, I got into all kinds of different styles of music. But when I picked up a guitar and started writing songs for the first time, it was the country and the R&B that came out. Now, all the music business folks up in Nashville, they told me, they said, man, you know, hey, this just never gonna work. This isn't country. It's just never gonna work. You need to do something about it. But, by the grace of God, a fellow who I've been riding around listening to a few years earlier, Kenny Chesney. Yeah. So he comes along, and he hears this song that I've written, and he recorded it, and he put it on the radio. And I knew that I had to make a record as an artist the first time that I heard him on the radio singing. Turn the CD off, turn it on again. Stand at the place where the fantasy spins around. Counting that track, clocking right away. Talking to myself, anything to make a sound. So the point I want to make with all this, and this is something I've realized here recently.
I guess the umbrellas in my raincoat.
This is the first generation that grew up with the internet. You know, whether you grew up way out in the sticks, in the big city, or somewhere in between, you had access to the world. You know, and now we have all kinds of music on our cell phones. And our parents didn't have that. And people in America have more in common today than they ever have. And no generation has ever been as culturally integrated as this one. This generation, y'all don't pay attention to genres of music. You don't pay attention to genres of people. Y'all listen to what makes you feel good, and you hang out with people you like, not people who look like you. I'm telling you, when this generation, when y'all take over, and it's already happened, now we're going to tear down some of the walls that have divided people in this country for a long, long time. And, you know, I say that because I want you to know the power I believe you have. And I mean that. I really do believe that. And I'm not preaching
to you guys, but
you know, in the spirit of getting to know each other a little bit, I wanted to share a little bit of what's been on my heart here lately. And with that being said, I want to say thank you, man, to every single person who showed up here tonight, from the very last seat up top to the very front. We appreciate the time. And thank you to Country Radio and all of our fans for allowing us to make the music we feel like we're supposed to make in 2017. Behind me back here. So let's get back to it.
Truck and tailgate, now just us, the speaker's on.